Hey, brother, there's an endless road to rediscover. Hey, sister, know the water's sweet, but blood is thicker. And oh, if the sky comes falling down for you, there's nothing in this world I wouldn't do. Hey, brother, do you still believe in one another? Hey, sister, do you still believe in love, I wonder? And oh, if the sky comes falling down for you, there's nothing in this world I wouldn't do. But if I'm far from home, oh brother, I will hear you call. But if I lose it all, oh sister, I will help you out. If the sky comes falling down for you, there's nothing in this world I wouldn't do.
Doing Catalyst, you mind standing with us? We're going to sing a few songs together in the worship of our God. We're continuing in a series called Name That Tune. We're looking at the book of Psalms and looking at how these songs are meant to shape us and form us as the people of God. Let's pray and get this day started. God, thank you so much for your goodness to us. We thank you for your love. We thank you for your grace. We thank you for this book, God, the book of Psalms that teaches us how to sing even when we can't put the words to our mouths. We ask all this in your son's name. Amen. Let's sing this song together. We've been singing it the last few weeks. It's called This Is Amazing Grace. Let's sing a song. Who breaks the power?
Who breaks the power of sin and darkness, whose love is mighty and so much stronger? The King of glory, the King above all kings. Who shakes the whole earth with holy thunder? Who leaves breathless in awe and wonder? The amazing grace. This is unfailing love. Now you would take my place. Now you would bear my cross. You laid down your life that I would be set free. Oh, Jesus, I sing for you've done for me.
Come
on. Who brings our chaos back into order? Who makes the orphan his son and daughter? The King of glory, the King of glory, who rules the nations justice, shine like the sun in all of its brilliance. The King of glory, the King above all kings. This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That you would take my place. That you would cross. You laid down your life that I would be set free.
Oh, Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy, worthy. This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That you would take my place. That you would bear my cross. You laid down your life that I would be set free.
How great is the love cross of our shame. He carried it all, and He rose from the grave. How great is the love, how great is the love of our Savior, of our Savior. Forgave us. Thank you for the way you have freed us. We have been ransomed, we've been rescued, we've been purchased with the price of your own. From the grave, how great is the love, how great is the love of our Savior, of our Savior.
Sing it out, thank you. Again, Jesus.
Jesus, faithful King, Lord with grace. Thank you.
Dear God, we're thankful for that love this morning. And I thank you that you pursue us. And I thank you that you chase us. I thank you that you love us where we are. And I thank you that we can't do enough or earn enough or be good enough for that that is freely given. I thank you for that today, God. I pray that you would be with us today, God. Not just today, but throughout this week and the days to come, I pray that you would help our response to your love be love back. God, that we love you with everything in us. God, that we love those around us, our community. God, I thank you for this church, and I thank you for these people. I thank you for the community. God, I thank you for Catalyst's presence in the community. Thank you for that. God, I pray that you would be with us today. I pray that you would be with Levi, God, as he proclaims what you've laid on his heart. I pray that he would do that boldly. God, I pray that you would be with us as we receive what he gives. I pray that you would let us quiet the noise of our busy lives for these few minutes. God, that we would be drawn in to you. God, that as we hear about the psalms that were sung in difficult times way, way back, it's not a whole lot different than the songs that we sing now. When we cry out for your mercy and your grace and your love, I thank you for that. God, I pray that you would be with every person in this room, with the different trials that they have going on. I pray that you would come in close. I pray that you would wrap your arms around us. I thank you for who you are. And I pray that everything that is said and done today points right back to you. In your name we pray. Amen.
Well, good morning. Welcome. Good to see everybody today. I hope everybody got a Beaker Mini. This is where you get some good information. Hey, let me run over just a couple things with you guys. Don't forget, June the 8th is graduation Sunday. That's if your kid is graduating from high school. So be sure and let Jonathan know, because we're going to have a little deal going on with pictures and all that kind of stuff. So also remember, this summer, take pictures with your Catalyst gear on. Go to wherever you're going on vacation, put on your Catalyst shirts, as I'm proudly sporting today. Thank you very much. And take a good picture and then send it, and we get some creative stuff going on and some prizes. Synthesis will meet tonight as regular, and then you're going to have a pool party next week. So that is going to be a cool way to get that cool way to start in the summer. That's good. All right, let's move on. All right, Beaker Mini, tear-off portion. We have this that we do in cool ways. And we did something different on the first service. We had what was called the slow tear. And it was awful, I thought. But Levi liked it. So in honor of Levi, we're going to do the slow tear. So you get to cheat a little bit. You get to pre-tear about an eighth of an inch, because it's hard to do a slow tear unless you've got a pre-tear. So this is complicated stuff. But we're going to slowly do the Beaker Mini tear on the count of three. One, two, three. All right. There's some information on here, some check boxes that you guys can read over. Down at the bottom, be sure and let us know how we can pray for you this week. We send out church-wide emails each week. If you don't want it to be included in that, you can check confidential, and the pastors are the only ones that will see that. But please let us know how we can pray for you. And if you'll flip it over, there's a place to put your name, who all came with you, want to know that you were here. You can check in electronically on Facebook if you'd rather do it that way. But whatever it is, make sure that we know that you were here. And if you fill this out, be sure and drop it in the tithe and connect box on your way out. And if you're a visitor, we just ask that you give us enough information so that we can say thanks. Maybe a name and an email address. We don't need all your stuff. We're not going to stalk you or hound you. We just want to say thanks that you were here. Now, we normally dismiss the kids at this time. However, we had about three kids show up for the lab, so we're going to have the kids stay in here with their parents today. But everybody else, stand up and say hello to someone next to you.
Good morning. Good enough. I want to start off by telling you that if you see me randomly scratching different parts of my body, I am covered head to toe in chiggers right now. I have gotten into chiggers before, but these, I'm very tasty to the chiggers in Cedar Hill State Park. Let me just be honest with you. It's horrible, actually, what's going on. All of these itching, all right? So if I start scratching, that's it, you know? And if I hit that thing like a, you know, a dog spot, my leg starts going, just forgive me, all right? Well, we are in this series, Name That Tune. And basically what we're doing is looking at some of these psalms that are in the book of Psalms. And we've had some fun with the theme on a couple of occasions, and I think we should continue that today. There are songs that, when they are played, they have a certain effect on us. Some songs cause us to move. My daughter is in a hip-hop dance class, and if you know my daughter, you know that she just reeks of hip-hop, right? I mean, the poor girl is paler than I am, but she's kind of found her place in this hip-hop dance class, and so she went through this phase a few months back where anytime an upbeat song would be playing through the house, she started gyrating, right? Just kind of these, not like a full-on dance, but just kind of like, you know, doing this kind of stuff, like all the time. Every time that there was a song on, it was, and it made me nervous, right? If we were in the room together, she was like moving and doing this stuff, and I could see it out of my peripheral vision, and so finally I was like, Addie, I was like, babe, you are an incredible dancer, but like every time a song comes on, like it's making me nervous with you like moving like that. And she just, with this look of like, just incredulous, right? She looks at me and she goes, Dad, I can't help it. It's just in me and has to come out, right? It's like, what do? You look at your 9-year-old daughter and tell her that she can't do that anymore? I'm like, all right, I'll deal with it. I'll deal with it. And so last night, as we are camping down at Cedar Hill State Park, we got a little Bluetooth speaker and playing some music, and then all of a sudden, we played this song, and everybody who had been sitting in a chair, not everybody, but several people, including some adults who had been sitting in a chair, like jumped up and just started like breaking it down, and there are certain songs that just do this to you. And as we started this series, I played this song, Happy, in here, and we're doing the same series with some other churches around the country. And my buddy pastors a church in Ohio, and they played that song, but after church, they played the song, and the kids heard it and rushed the stage. Somebody grabbed a camera, and they captured this. My buddy's son is right there in the middle. Got the karate chop going. Sprinkler. Start the lawnmower. Doing a Ryan Moriarty impression in the drum set there. All right, and they go on for like 2 or 3 minutes. I mean, these kids are just breaking it down, totally unrehearsed. They heard the music, jumped on the stage, and started dancing. Nobody had to tell them to do that, right? It was just, I guess, in them, and it just had to come out, right? Now, there are some of you that are saying, I don't relate to that at all. I've never been moved to physical movement by music. And to you, I say, I'm sorry, right? You're kind of missing out on a little bit of life. But maybe there are some of you that can relate that there are certain songs that when they come on, you can't help but sing, right? There are certain songs that come on the radio that are just singable. And so this week, we actually found a blog that lists the 25 most singable songs that have ever been written. And we put together a medley for you this morning, and it's going to play. And so as you hear the songs, you recognize them, you won't be able to help yourself. You will have to sing along. So here we go.
Sweet home Alabama, where the skies are blue. Sweet home Alabama, but I'm coming home to you. We gotta hold on to what we've got. It doesn't make a difference if we make it or not. We got each other, and that's a lot for
us. Right. Right, sing it out. Sing it out.
Take my hand. We'll make it, I swear. Don't stop believing. Hold on to that feeling. Street light.
Man, you got to use your falsetto on that one. I don't know any of these words, but we've all heard this song.
Scaramouche, scaramouche, will you do the fandango? Thunderbolts and lightning, very, very frightening me.
Galileo, Galileo,
Galileo, Galileo,
Figaro.
Magnifico! I'm just a poor boy and nobody loves me.
He's just a poor boy from a poor family, sparing his life from this monstrosity.
Easy come, easy go, will you let me go?
Bismillah,
no, we will not let you go.
Let him go.
Bismillah,
we will not let you go.
Let him go.
Bismillah,
we will not let you go.
Let me go.
We will not let you go.
Let me go.
We will not let you go.
Never let me go.
Oh, mamma mia, mamma mia.
Mamma mia, let me go. Beelzebub has a devil put aside for me. For me.
Touching hands, reaching out, touching me, touching you.
You know you've written a memorable song when everybody vocalizes the instruments, right? Bum, 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 and all of you, you're all doing that, right? There are some songs that you just have to sing along to. You see, we sing when we're happy, we sing when we're sad, we sing when we're bored, we sing when we are excited. There are a lot of shows out there on TV where they try to identify the best solo artist. My kids and I, on a regular basis, watch The Voice or American Idol to find these solo artists that haven't been discovered yet. But if I'm honest, I believe that we are actually at our best as humans, as the church, when we sing together. When we come in here each and every week and we sing to our God with each other, for each other. It's the one thing that we can all do at the exact same time. It's the one thing that brings us together. It unifies us. And so we don't just sing songs to sing songs. It isn't just something to kill some time. It helps us to join our voices, to join our hearts. And one of the things that I love most about Catalyst is that we are a singing church. As our vocalists back away from the microphones, there is not silence in this church. It's not a show going on up here. And there are dozens of churches that you can walk into that do the same style of music that we do, that if the vocalists were to dare to back away from the mic, there would be crickets, there would be silence, because people are just standing there watching, but not at Catalyst. We are a singing church. And I know that there are many weeks that you enter and leave this room and you were moved more by the singing than you were the preaching. Now, I don't want a bunch of amens right there, right? I know one of you smart Alex. Amen, preach it, brother. Almost every week. You know, no. I'll listen to this thing back. I'll figure out who you are, and there will be lots of forks in your front yard. All right? It has happened.
Amen.
That's right. Went down in Wiley. And here's the deal. We need to face it. There are certain songs that we need to sing, even when we don't feel like it. Not to conjure up some fake emotion to psych ourselves up. Not because of that, but because we need to be reminded of who God is. We need to be reminded of what He has done, of His faithfulness to His people. There are times that in my humanity, I walk in and I realize that we are going to have to sing a song that I don't particularly feel. There are times that I walk in, and as the pastor, I don't have this overwhelming sense that God has been really good in the week leading up to our time together. And sure enough, there on the list is a song that asks me to sing. You are good, when there's nothing good in me. That's why I don't sing in a microphone, right? But I come in here and I sing words to songs that don't necessarily jive with where my heart is in that moment. Why? Because I need to be reminded of who God is, of His faithfulness, of how He has moved on our behalf in the past. And the psalm that we have for today, it does this exactly. It's a song of thanksgiving that remembers God's goodness, His faithfulness, and the past work that He has done. And so it's a little bit longer, but we're going to read it. Psalm 66. It says, "Shout for joy to God, all the earth. Sing the glory of His name. Make His praise glorious. Say to God, how awesome are your deeds. So great is your power that your enemies cringe before you. All the earth bows down to you. They sing praise to you. They sing the praises of your name. Come and see what God has done, His awesome deeds for humankind. He turned the sea into dry land, and they passed through the waters on foot. Come, let us rejoice in Him. He rules forever by His power. His eyes watch the nations. Let not the rebellious rise up against Him. Praise our God, all peoples. Let the sound of His praise be heard. He has preserved our lives and kept our feet from slipping, for You, God, tested us. You refined us like silver. You brought us into prison and laid burdens on our backs. You let people ride over our heads. We went through fire and water. You brought us to a place of abundance. I will come to Your temple with burnt offerings and fulfill my vows to You, vows my lips promised and my mouth spoke when I was in trouble. I will sacrifice fat animals to You and an offering of rams. I will offer bulls and goats. Come and hear, all you who fear God. Let me tell you what He has done for me. I cried out to Him with my mouth. His praise was on my tongue. If I had cherished sin in my heart, the Lord would not have listened, but God has surely listened and has heard my prayer. Praise be to God, who has not rejected my prayer or withheld His love from me." This is a song that the people of God would come together and that they would sing together. And if you weren't here the first week, what we have come to understand is that the book of Psalms, 150 songs, it was compiled while the Israelites were exiles in Babylon, right? So this is a songbook that was put together after the people of God had been pulled from their city and taken to a foreign land. Their city had been ransacked. It had been burned. Their friends and family members had been killed in the battle that happened there. And so here they are. They find themselves as exiles. There was a forced deportation to a foreign land under foreign rulers. And they would gather together as the people of God. And under those circumstances, they would sing that song. Praise be to our God. Whew. Does it line up with the circumstances they were in? No, but the psalm tells the story of God's provision for them, provision out of slavery, his preservation of their lives during the time that they were slaves. This psalm remembers when he brought them to the place of abundance. We hear the words, come and hear, come and see. They knew the importance of telling and retelling the stories of God's provision for his people, his protection over his people. And so sometimes we need to sing the song of what God has done to be reminded of what God can do. In the middle of the ugliness of life, the hurt, the pain, the struggle, there are times that we need to pull out our Bible, we need to pull up our app and flip it to Psalm 66 and give thanks to God for who he is and remember his faithfulness to his people. Because this is what God's people have done generation after generation after generation. Sometimes the songs that we need to sing together are these songs that remind us of who God has been so we know who he will continue to be. And so today, we sang a couple songs before the sermon. The only response that I know of that we can have to these words is to sing, right? To sing of who God is, to come and listen to the story of God's provision and his faithfulness. I'm going to pray, and the band is going to come, and they're going to lead us this morning. Father, there are songs that we know well, and there are songs that we like to sing, and then there are songs that are really, really difficult for us to sing, depending on the season of life we find ourselves in. And so, Father, I pray that no matter the circumstance that we are in, no matter where we find ourselves, that we would be a people who, like the generations who have gone before us, turn to your word. And while we may not sing these words exactly collectively, that we would be reminded that you are a God who provides, you are a God who protects, you are a God who loves us. Father, may you be blessed. May you be honored. May you be glorified. May you be lifted up as we make a joyful noise and sing of your goodness. And remember that you are a faithful God. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Would you stand as we sing together this morning? have a seat for the next few minutes. These are the hardest words that I've ever spoken at Catalyst. 7 years ago, the Lowry crew, we needed a place to go, and the opportunity to move from North Carolina to Texas fell in our laps. We said a big yes to God, and we moved from Burlington, North Carolina to Rowlett, Texas in June of 2007. We got here, we settled in, and said another big yes to God when we realized that we needed to adjust our original plans and start a rock and roll church that focused on families with young kids. We said yes to God many times as we moved from rented church to living room to a bonus room to an elementary school to Stillwater Community Church to the Cinemark Theater. We let out a collective sigh when we finally moved into our current facility. We said yes to God as we felt Him challenging us to be a church that reaches into the community. We said yes to being a church that filters everything we do and don't do through the core values of loving, growing, and serving. We said yes as God began to bring in new people, young people, older people, hurting people, people in need of healing, restoration, and salvation that only comes through Christ. We said yes to God when He began to fill our lives with relationships that we did not know were possible outside of real flesh and blood. And now we are saying one of the most difficult yeses that we have said in 7 years, actually in all of our years. We are saying yes to a new adventure, an adventure that will allow us to live very close to family for the first time in 14 years as a family. And in order to say this yes, we have to say one of the hardest goodbyes we will ever say. On Thursday evening, I submitted my resignation as lead pastor of Catalyst to the leadership team, effective the end of June. In July, the Lowry family will move to Florida. It's important to me that you understand a few things, that you hear my heart. There are not problems behind the scenes at Catalyst. There is not a rift between the leadership team and myself. There are not problems between Jonathan and me. To the best of my knowledge, there isn't a single person that has an issue with me personally or with Catalyst as a church. There are no power players running me out of town. In fact, there are no power players calling the shots at Catalyst, period. There has not been a moral failure of any sort. I have not cheated, stolen, lied, or anything else that you could imagine along those lines. I am not hooked on drugs, alcohol, or prescription meds. Disc golf. Maybe disc golf. Heather and I are enjoying a marriage that is honestly stronger and healthier than it has ever been. Our marriage is not on the rocks. I'm not going to another church to be their pastor. This is not a grass is greener somewhere else scenario. I've said many times, this is the only place that I could ever pastor. I believe those words to be true. God wires each of us differently. I'm a people person. I energize and am energized by working in a team setting. And honestly, much of what I do now is done in solitude behind computer screens, books, ebooks, commentaries, blogs, and articles. It takes me a ridiculously long time to write a sermon each and every week, usually between 16 and 25 hours. I have struggled for years with this part of my role. It got to a point where I needed to step back and evaluate what ministry looks like for me. And when I did, it was crystal clear that I needed to step away from the lead pastor role. It's important to me that you understand that I have fought to overcome and to stay. I have worked with ministry coaches and counselors, and at the end of the day, there is a stress and a tightness in my chest that I can't escape and can't make disappear. It makes no sense, as Catalyst is honestly one of the easiest churches on the planet Earth to pastor. This is about dying to self and being fully alive in Christ. It's about obedience no matter what. I've said many times that I was never called to build or grow God's church, that I've been called to be faithful. In order to continue in faithfulness, this is a step that we need to make as a family. Spraying is staying put. He gets Catalyst. He knows who we are. The truth is, he's kind of stuck with you, and you're kind of stuck with him, because there simply aren't other Nazarene churches that know what to do with our wild man. Your leadership team, along with Spring, will be doing the work of evaluating and taking steps to lead Catalyst into the future. Spring, along with the leadership team, they will be the ones to decide who comes in here next. Nobody else gets to just plug a lunatic into my place. You've had one lunatic already. That God would ever choose to use me in a ministry capacity is beyond my wildest imagination. But he has. What God has done at Catalyst blows my mind. And Heather, Addie, Keegan, and myself are better because of our time here. We love you guys. I've asked Jonathan to come and pray because he and Heather both said that they couldn't sing after this. So Jonathan, brother, if you would pray.
God, we thank you for your love and goodness. We know that you are always with us, and we have confessed that constantly over the last few months. We also know from experience that there are times in life when your presence is tangible and we have a peace that cannot be explained. We pray that in the next few weeks and months that you would bring us that peace. We pray that you would be with Levi and Catalyst in this difficult time where we have questions and tears. Bring us your peace. Help us to see your hand at work. May this season be one that we grow closer to you through the pain, and may it not cause us to leave your side. We love Levi, and we love you, and we need you now more than ever to navigate these waters. We pray all this in the name of the Father, and the Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Sometimes we need to sing these words in the midst of a difficult time, so I will sing. Shout for joy to God, all the earth. Sing the glory of his name. Make his praise glorious. Say to God, how awesome are your deeds. So great is your power that your enemies cringe before you. All the earth bows down to you. They sing praise to you. They sing the praises of your name. So Catalyst, may the one who can bring all grace, comfort, and mercy lead us in the days ahead. May you live in that grace and in that peace. We will see you next week.